सदाशिवसमारम्भाम् शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्।
Today we'll continue the same our spiritual debates. Everybody had darshan morning in the temple, Badri Vishal. Then everybody, all of you guys, did you guys go to the Vyas Gupha? Anybody was not able to walk? All of you went to that Mana. Saraswati. You saw the Saraswati Dwar? How the river is disappearing. Did you guys see that pit where it disappears? So you see, the happening of the water in planet Earth happened in that spot. So that is the spot where the happening of the planet water happened in the planet Earth. So that's a space where the civilization started. That is a space where civilization started. Even the NASA's pictures clearly describes exactly that is the space where the water got into the earth and started filling all the underground holes. Then one stream broke the earth and started coming out, that is a Gomukh. And still in Gomukh, please understand, beyond Gomukh there is no clear source for Ganga. It's just underground water. That's one thing. There one stream came up and just stood stagnant. That's Manasarovar. One stream went straight and broke the ground in Prayag. That is a Saraswati in Prayag. So the happening of the water on planet Earth happened in that spot. Actually, that happening only we call as the Ganga came down, Shiva's jata, it got caught, and Shiva released it, and it came to the planet Earth. So that whole thing. And not only that, it went away, went inside the ground. That is what the story says. The Jannu Maharshi was meditating. Jannu is the planet Earth. He just swallowed it. So then again Bhagiratha did tapas. All you guys are aware of the story. All of you are able to hear. So then Jannu Maharshi released through the ears. That's why she is called Jahnavi. The different names. It's a beautiful story. Then when the Ganga came out of Janu's ears, she is called Jahnavi. That coming out of the Ganga's ears is what is the place before the Gomukh. Then it comes out of the Nandi's mouth. So our mythological stories are visual representation of the astronomical happenings. Whatever happened actually, visually gets represented. As I said yesterday, see the story of Noah's Ark. Almost in all religious traditions and all theosophies, all theologies speak about that Noah's Ark. There is a fifth layer. Naturally, when you experience the fifth layer, this happens. And that experience happens in you. So that's what is represented by these theories, by the story. The Big Bang which happened, that is what they describe as Shiva stood as a light shaft and the Brahma and Vishnu searched for the head and tail. That story is a Big Bang theory only. And the black hole only is described as a Mahapralaya, where everything resides into the Vishnu and he resides into the Vishala. So here also they call Badri Vishal, means the Vishal, the expansion. The expansion which you experience when you go there is Vishal. See, you are put in a certain low TPS when you go there. Certain temperature, certain atmosphere, certain things. Suddenly, you are in a low TPS, you experience Vishal. And that very place is such, neither your eyes are gone into the open sky, nor your eyes experience cornered concrete jungle. See, if you are constantly in a space where you are
shut by the concrete jungle, you can never experience Vishal means the part of your brain which is responsible for your boundary. There is a part of your brain which constantly reminds you about your boundary. 10 feet from this building, 11 feet from this building, 2 feet from this building, from this floor. That part, if it is constantly in a concrete jungle, does not get activated. And same way, if it is completely in the open sky, gets perturbed or agitated, does not know. But a kind of a neither concrete jungle nor measurable. That is the spot where that non-mechanical parts of the brain which speaks, reminds you about your boundary, gets awakened, gives you the experience of Vishala. Please understand, if you just lie down and stare at the whole open sky, even that non-mechanical part of the brain, that will not get activated. That may get just sleeping. That may just become silent, dumb. Or if you are constantly in the space of concrete jungle, again it will not get activated. You need a kind of a space where there is no neither concrete jungle nor a simple open sky, where there is enough right amount of challenge for that part of the brain and the right possibility of expansion. When that happens, that part suddenly expands and gives you the experience of boundarylessness, Vishala. So the Badri is the spot, the Vishala happens for many people. At least 90% of the people, because of the raised altitude, less TPS, and the atmosphere is such, the Vishala experience happens. That's why we go there. We don't go there just to see that small deity, you understand? We go there to experience that Badri Vishal.
So what does that have to do with Vishnu?
See, Vishnu means the cosmos.
Space.
And the whole. That's a Vishnu.
So how did Vishnu become enlightened if he's already enlightened?
See, that's a symbol of the person. See, when those masters land in the body, when he landed in the body, he meditated there and experienced his original state. See, after few years, I'll also worship you as a god. Then there will be question, how did he become enlightened in Thiruvannamalai in that spot?
Right, right.
I experienced my nature in that spot. That's all.
So it was the pure form of Vishnu.
Eh?
The pure form of Vishnu
yes.
Experienced himself in that spot.
See, the form of Vishnu experienced the formlessness of Vishnu.
Yes, yes.
So the Vishal, many of your non-mechanical parts of the brain gives you the different higher experiences. One more thing, these higher experiences are not just fantasies or visions. When they get stored in your system, they get translated as extraordinary powers in your biomemory. That is what we call siddhis. See, for example, this Vishal experience, the boundaryless experience, that part of the brain when it gets awakened, it gets settled in your system such a way that many of your organs are always in ecstasy. So naturally less hunger, less need for things from the outside, and more clarity and the understanding of what is going on in other persons. That is what happens in the biomemory. That's what we call siddhis.
What is the difference between Mahima?
Mahima and Vishal. Understand, see, when Mahima happens, it starts expanding and after a certain level, breaks. When this Vishal happens also, it starts expanding, after a certain level, it breaks. I can say, Mahima is the biomemory name of that Vishal's experience expression. Vishal can be the brain alternative states experience of Mahima's biomemory. See, when the same thing happens, if you look at from the angle of the non-mechanical parts of the brain and name that, it's Vishal. If you look at from the angle of biomemory and name it Mahima.
From a physics point of view, we can explain Mahima.
So the same thing, we can explain this. See, when they did research on my brain, they said that the part which talks about boundary, which tells you about boundary, is completely, it is not functioning. Of course, I am aware, I am alive, sitting, aware. But he says, no, there is no idea about boundary in you, Swamiji. Means, that part will be responsible for Mahima. If you dig out more with the idea of brain, which part is responsible for reminding you constantly from the how many feet you are, from the things around.